Today, the physical education teacher going to teach basketball skills, rules and regulation of the games and dimension of the court. But dear students, before start the session, we want to show you wonderful basketball court in our school playground.
You know what spreads faster than any virus? It's fear. Now when it comes to fear, you can either forget everything and run. I say ah! Or you can face everything and rise.
I believe.
And let me tell you what I believe.
I believe that.
I believe we will face everything.
I believe that we will win.
You fall, it's how you get back up, and what don't kill us make us stronger, boy. Bet that up, take a swing at us.
Dear students, have you seen lovely basketball court in our school playground? Fine. So now I'm going to start my basketball session, and I'm going to teach history of the game and dimension of the court and the general rule regulation of the court. Actually, dear children, in basketball there is so many rules and regulations and dimension of the court. Time is very limited, so I am going to teach in brief fine. So basketball actually game invented in 1891 in Massachusetts. And James Nash Smith started this game, fine. And now I'm going to explain dimension of the court. Okay, students. Dimension of the court, actually length of the basketball court is 28 meters. From here to end of the line, fine. And width of the court from here to end of the court, that is 15 meters, fine. And you can see here, height of the ring from ground surface to near the ring is, that is 3.5 centimeter, fine. And every students, every line marked with 5 centimeters, width of 5 centimeters. All the lines, borders, you can see white lines is here. It's border lines. Every line marked with 5 centimeters. And one more thing I want to add on in this in dimension part. Weight, size of the ball is for girls. Number size is 6 and for boys size is number 7 for the basketball match, fine. And basketball match, dear students, there are 4 quarters and each quarters divided into 10 minutes, fine. First quarter 10 minutes, after that 2 minutes break. Between the quarters actually 2 minutes break is there. After that means 10 to 10, after that 5 minutes break, that is interval or half time. After that again 2 quarters after half time, it's 10 minutes, then 2, then 10. So this is the duration of the basketball match or game, fine. And 5 players basically playing this game, but 12 players are required in one basketball team. And 5 best players are playing basketball match or games, fine. After that, there is some general rule regulations, but I am going to teach a brief, because in basketball, children, earlier or before I might start the session, already I have told you, actually in basketball there is so many rules and regulations and dimensions. But in online classes, it's not possible to us. That is why I'm going to teach you brief. Fine. So actually, there is some rules for 5 seconds, 3 seconds, 8 seconds, and 24 seconds. Second rules is actually you cannot not hold the ball more than 5 seconds. Within the 5 seconds, you have to pass your another player. Fine. Otherwise, if you will not pass the ball within the 5 seconds, ball is dead. So opponent will get chance. Fine. And there is a 3 second rules is also here while playing the match. And here is a border, white border in square manner. You can see here that is a restricted area. Fine. Actually, 3 second rule in basketball games, 3 seconds rule is there, and we called this area is restricted area. Fine. That means with you cannot hold while the playing when you are going to attempt the shoot or going to take a shot. So within 3 seconds, if you are standing in this area, in restricted area, so within 3 seconds you have to take one attempt. Fine. Otherwise there is foul and ball is dead and official will blow the whistle. Fine. So this is the rule of 3 seconds. 5 seconds already I have told you. And one another rules in basketball, that is 8 seconds. 8 seconds means from here, starting the line, this line, when you take the ball, your partner will give the ball for start the match. So you within 8 seconds, means from here to center line, you can see here, this line. So this line to that line, fine. Within this area, you have to cross the ball for attempting the basketball shoot. Otherwise, again, ball is dead and official will blow the whistles and ball is dead and there is foul. So within 8 seconds, you have to cross the center line, fine. Then actually total duration of one attempt in basketball, that is 24 seconds, fine. So within 24 seconds, you have to take one attempt. One attempt means one shoot when start the game. So within 24 seconds, you have to take one attempt, otherwise ball is again dead. So within 24 seconds, these are the classified all the seconds, 5 second rules, 3 second rules and 8 second rules. Every seconds it's divided into 24 seconds, fine. So you have to take one attempt in basketball, fine. So dear children, so after this session, now we are going to come in main session, that is fundamental skills in basketball, fine. And before start the any skills, first one more thing I want to share in this session, students. Actually, basketball game is not body contact game, fine. It's not body contact game. If you are touched, there is foul, but there is some you easily understand the rules and regulations, dimension of the court and brief history in basketball, fine. After this, now we are going to start fundamental skills, fine. But before this, actually always keep in your mind, students, basketball game is not body contact game, fine. This is not body contact game. So when you are going to play a match or game, so always keep in your mind, do not touch the player. Intentionally do not touch the player. That is the main rule in basketball. Otherwise, always opponent get chance. Fine, means there is foul. your teacher or instructor or coach will tell you. But intentionally you cannot push, intentionally you cannot touch the players. Right. And in basketball, fundamental skills, dear students, already I have told you on basketball there is important part is how to handling the ball and basic stance of the game. Fine. So first we will learn basic stance in basketball. Fine. How to stand, how to take basic stance. Arun sir will perform how to take basic stance. In this, what we have to do, children? We have to do feet apart according to your shoulder level. Arun sir will do, you can see, feet apart according to your shoulder level. Yes, you have to stand like this when you are entering the basketball or when you are performing any skill in the basketball. So you have to take basic stance only this. Fine. Why we have take feet according to shoulder level? Because our center of gravity is more stable, because our body weight is equally distributed, so that we have to take like this basic stance. Fine. After this, next part is how to handling the ball. Fine. In this, what we have to do, first we have to do hold the ball. First of all, you have to keep your ball according to your chest, in front of the chest. In this, you have to hold the ball tightly and spread your finger on the ball. You can see, Arun sir will perform. See, keep your elbow forward, Arun, slightly, yes. Slightly bent, slightly, yes. And you have to keep the ball tightly, fine. Arun, please come forward. I'll show you. If you will not hold tightly, then what happened? See, means opponent will get the chance. Opponent will take the ball easily when you will hold the ball loosely. Fine. So you have to hold the ball tightly. Then opponent will not get the chance like this. Fine. So you have to take. You have to hold the ball like this. This is first part is how to handling the ball. Then next one is keep your hands in upper direction. See, keep your hands, both hands, you have to keep your both hands in upper direction and hold tightly with your palm and change the ball one hand to another hand and tap your ball with your fingertips like this. Arun sir will do, see. 20 times, 50 times, you have to perform, or one set, two set, means 20 repetitions, two sets, three sets you have to perform or you have to do. So easily you will accumulate the ball. Basically, why we do basic stance or basic handling the ball in basketball? Because when beginners come for learn the skills, so easily students familiar with the ball, fine, accumulated with the ball, fine, so that we perform handling the ball. When we start or when we teach the fundamental skills, so before fundamental skills, students or children will learn how to handling the ball because they accumulated with the ball. Fine. Third part is next how to handling the ball. You have to hold your ball like this and pass the ball over your back and front. 5 to 6 times one side, means right side, and 5 to 6 times another side. And you can include 10 times, 20 times or one rep set for 20 repetitions. So it's depend on your capability or capacity, you can add on, fine. So Arun sir will do next how to handling the ball. See. And your vision should be straight. Don't see the ball. You have to see straight. See in back direction. Another side also sir will do. You can see another side. Yes. See. 20 times, 50 times, many times you can do when you are learn basketball. Fine. So these are the fundamental handling the ball. First one I have taught, keep your ball in front of your chest and hold tightly. Fine. And your feet should be equally distributed, means your feet should be feet apart according to your shoulder level. Then next, you have to keep your hands in upper direction and change your ball. You can see Arun sir is doing, and you can change the ball one hand to another hand with your fingertip like this. You can see. Fine. After this, keep your ball again in front of your chest and roll the ball, means pass the ball over your back and front 10 times, 15 times, then another side you have to with your fingertips, with the help of your fingertips. Then next one is, that is last one actually. You have to keep your ball near your right side or left side, near the feet, and tap the ball with the help of your fingers, fine, fingertips, and roll the ball in forward direction up to center line or up to end of the court. Fine. And in this also you have to do 5 times, 6 times, 7 times. It depends on your capability or capacity. Fine. Alcohol was freely used in crew quarters. Arun sir will demonstrate you how to do this activity actually. So Arun sir will tap the ball and roll the ball up to center line. Slowly, slowly he will tap the ball. See, this is also one of the skill in basketball, that is handling the ball. Already I have told you, when beginners will come, they will learn this type of activities before start the fundamental skills. Fine. After handling the ball, now we are going to learn dribbling in basketball. Fine. Actually, in basketball, two types of dribbling. That is low dribble and high dribble. Low dribble means below the knee, means when you are going to start dribbling, so you have to do below the knee. Dribbling will be below the knee, that is low dribble. You can see Arun sir will do, this is a low dribble. And another hand should be in blocking position. Fine. Below the knee, you can see below the knee, that is low dribble. Yes, this is low dribble. And second is high dribble, means below the waist. Ball should be not goes up to waist level. Below the knee, you have to control the ball. See, like this. forcefully you have to push the ball. Your hand, your palm should be forcefully tap the ball. Fine. You can see. This is high dribble. Okay, well, children, I hope this session is beneficial for you. And in this session, we have delivered history of the basketball, brief history of the basketball, dimension of the court, and general rule regulation of the basketball. Fine. After this, we learned how to handling the ball, basic stance in basketball, then types of fundamental skills. That is one basic. First one is dribble. That is two types: low dribble and high dribble. Fine. After this session, again we will meet in second session with other fundamental skills. So during COVID-19, students, don't go out. Stay fit, stay healthy. Till then, bye bye.